Hello students, today we are starting our chemistry portion. I hope you are working on with your biology portion is also. So I am giving you some information related to that chemistry portion. So we are starting our 6th chapter, that is the physical and the chemical changes. So that is a part of your science and it's a part of the chemistry. So first of all we are starting from these chapters. So we are just going to first of all introducing about some changes. So what is the meaning of the changes? The changes means when one thing is converting into the another things by changing its color, by changing its shapes, or by changing its properties. So these factors are known as the changes. And on the behalf of the changing its shapes, color, size, as well as its properties, we are saying change take place. Okay? But here we are talking about generally two changes. The first change is a physical, another change is chemical. What is the difference between the physical and chemical change? Generally guys, there are two words are mean. The first is the physical. The physical means related to their shape, related to their smell, related to their color. Okay. So if these changes are occurring in any phase of matter, so these are known as the physical change. Chemical means these are generally molecular changes. Molecular changes. Okay, suppose when we are going to make a food, so we are adding the rice and some spices and we are going to heat. So after heating of 15 or 20 minutes, they're giving us some new kind of dishes. So we are not able to separate the spice, water, rice from these dishes, because this dishes is an integrated form of the different molecular changes. So such type of changes generally known as the chemical changes, okay? But physical changes is only related to its shape, smell and its color. So today we are talking about the kinds of changes in our environment as well as in our atmosphere. So I am giving you the examples of the changes here. The examples of the first changes is, we starting from the physical changes. So see. The physical changes. So how we define the physical changes? When any substances changes into one phase to the another phase without changing its properties. So such kind of changes is known as the physical change. When you are going to convert one compound or one substance into the another substance, they change, but they are not changing their properties. Without properties, properties means they are not changing any chemical changes, are not occurring here. They are only changing their shape, size, smell, but the molecular changes is not occur. So that changes is known as the physical changes. I am giving you one example. Suppose if you are taking a glass of water, okay? Suppose we are taking a glass of water, then the water, it is available in their liquid state. But what happened? We are going for the cooling process. After half an hour, the whole water is freeze. The whole water is freeze. That state is known as the ice. Okay. The same as well, if we are heating, if we are provide heat. So when we are heating that water at a high temperature, the water will be evaporate. At that time, water is available in which phase? Vapor phase. This vapor phase is known as the gas. So here, the formula of water is H2O. In solid phase also its formula is H2O. In vapor phase its formula is H2O. So guys, here only physical state is changing. Here the liquid state change into ice. Here the liquid state is changing into gas. But the formula as well as remain same. So only the physical state is changing. They are changing in their shape and size. but their constituent and their molecules are not changing, they are remaining as well as same in all phases. Here also H2, here also H2, and here also H2. The such changes in which only the physical state are changing, they are not changing in their molecules. So that changes is known as the physical changes. So वो changes जिसमें compound की केवल physical state change होती है, उसके molecules में कोई changes नहीं आते, उसके constituents में कोई changes नहीं आते, that changes is known as the physical changes. Okay? The next example of the physical changes, the next examples of the physical changes are tearing of paper. Suppose we are taking a piece of paper, that is a piece of paper, and then we cut down with the help of scissor. We just making a different shape of this paper, triangle, square, circle. So when we just going to cut down this paper with the help of scissor and making it different shapes, so what happened? The paper changing their shapes, but their chemical properties is not changing. Their chemical behavior, their particles is not changing. Suppose this paper is made up of cellulose. Cellulose is a chemical. So here cellulose is remain cellulose. Here also. Here the paper is only changing its shapes, but its chemical constituents always remain same. So here this paper is made up of cellulose. After cutting paper, again cellulose is here. The cellulose is not changing. Their chemical composition is not changing, but they are only changing in their shape. So the properties or the changes when the compound only changing its shapes, but they are not changing their chemical properties like their constituent. जिससे ये बना होता है वो चीजें changes नहीं होती. The such changes is known as the physical changes. Okay. So these are the examples of the physical changes in which the compound only changing their shape, size, color, but they are not changing their chemical properties. So such changes is known as the physical changes. Okay. So that is the best example of the physical changes. The next example related to our environment, weather. So if you are talking about the weather, after some time the lots of clouds is appearing. Okay. The whole atmosphere is changing, but after some time when the wind is blowing, the cloud is moving with the winds, and at that after 5 minutes the whole sky is clear. So any changes is there? No, only the cloud changing their shapes and moving one place to the another place. No chemical changes take place, only the physical changes is take place. The sky is blue, but after the covered by the clouds its appearance like a white, they only changing its color. Okay, so no chemical changes is take place, no particle changes is take place. So such type of changes is known as the physical changes. Okay, so this one is the example of the physical changes. So next example is, next definitions we are going to define chemical changes. See what happening in chemical changes, that changes is continuously take place inside your body. So the next one is a chemical changes. So what is the chemical changes when compound change or convert one phase to the another phase by changing its shape and particles or chemical composition. So see guys, here shape is also changing as well as its particles, or we say chemical composition also changing. So that changes is known as the chemical changes. Okay, so what is the chemical changes? The changes in which a compound is converting into the one phase to the another phase. By the when they are converting one phase to the another phase, they changing their shape as well as they changing their chemical compositions are known as the chemical change. So what happened here when the one compound converting into one form to the another forms? Okay, they giving you a new compounds. A new substance is formed. A new substance is formed. But what happened in physical changes? No new substance is formed. Physical changes mein kya hua tha? When water is converting liquid to solid in ice, so only physical state is changed. The water is not giving you any new substance. Only the state is changed, liquid to solid. But what happened in chemicals? When one compound is going to change into the another compounds, they giving you a new substance. Here physical state is changing as well as a new substance is formed. But in physical state, no new substance is formed, only its physical state is changing. I'm giving you an example of the chemical changes. See, in case of the chemical changes, the decomposition of food, example is respiration. Respiration, you know guys, respiration is a process take place inside your body, breakdown of food. When you are eating the large amount of food, it's going inside your body and food will be decomposed and giving you energy. So that type of changes is known as the chemical change. Again, this energy is not converting into food. Kya us energy ko aap dobara food mein convert kar sakte hain? Nahi. So such changes is known as the non-reversible changes. The chemical changes is also known as the non-reversible changes. Wo changes jinko hum convert backward direction mein convert nahi kar sakte. But physical changes are reversible changes. जैसे आपने water से ice बनाया, तो ice को दोबारा किस में convert कर सकते हैं? Heat करके water में. So that changes, physical changes are the convertible changes or reversible changes. But the chemical changes are non-reversible because when one substance converted into the another substance, we are not able to convert another into the previous substance. I'm giving you example. Suppose if you are eating food, that food is decomposed inside your body in the presence of oxygen. That processes take place inside the cell and food giving you carbon dioxide as well as water and giving you energy. So here the food is converting into carbon dioxide. Are you able to convert this carbon dioxide into food? No. This is a one directional process. So here a new substance is formed in chemical changes. The whole food converting into carbon dioxide, water and energy. So those reactions or those process in which a new type of substance is formed is known as the chemical changes. And the chemical changes is always moving forward direction. They are not able to move on backward direction. Ye hamesha aage ki taraf ko move karte hain, piche ki taraf ko move nahi karte. The next example is rusting. You know the rusting of iron, jise aap bolte hain zang lagna. Okay. The next example is rusting of iron. So see, the example is rusting of iron. So the rusting of iron, if you are taking an iron nail, okay, and dip this nail in water and you are also supplying oxygen from outside. So this nail when come to the contact with water and oxygen, it will be rusted. The red color shapes or red color powder is appearing here. This is known as the rust. So if any iron object is come to the contact with the moisture and air, it will be rusted. Have you seen the lots of example in your daily life, in your homes and your surrounding atmosphere? If any iron object is come to the contact with the air as well as the moisture, they cause rusting. So un iron objects mein kya lag jata hai? Zang. So here the one iron object is converted into rust. But we are not able to convert this rust into again this iron nail. Okay, so this is also a non-reversible process. In this reaction, the heavy object of iron is converted into the rust. The new type of compound is formed, rust. So in chemical changes, a new type of substance is formed. But in physical changes, no new type of substance is formed. Okay, so here the iron nail is able to convert into this rust. But what happened? We are not able to convert this rust again into this iron nail. So it is a one directional process. It's always taking it forward direction. It's not able to proceed on the backward direction. So always the chemical changes is a one directional changes. Here, or we say in the chemical changes, a new type of substance is formed. So here the rust is formed, is a new type of substance. A rust powder is formed. from this iron nail. So that is the type of this which can process chemical changes or chemical process. The next example I'm showing you the chemical changes, burning of candle. Okay, burning candle or burning process. See guys, if we are taking a piece of paper, that is a piece of paper, and we start heat. With the help of heat, we just burn this paper, and this paper convert into carbon, a black color carbon. A black carbon is formed and they release carbon dioxide gas. So see guys, here a new substance is formed. फिजिकल चेंजेस में आपने क्या करा था, इस पेपर के पीस करे थे, तो पेपर के पीस छोटे छोटे पीस में डिवाइड हो गए. They only changing in their shape in case of the physical change, but no new type of substance is formed there. But here what happened, when we start burn a piece of paper, it converting into a carbon dioxide and they converting into a black color substance. So are you able to convert this black color substance into again this paper? No. जो भी चीज बर्न होती है तो उसको दोबारा हम प्रीवियस फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट नहीं कर सकते. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द केमिकल चेंजेस. सो इन द केमिकल चेंजेस अ न्यू टाइप ऑफ सब्सटेंस इज फॉर्म एंड वी आर नॉट एबल टू कन्वर्ट दिस न्यू सब्सटेंस इनटू द प्रीवियस सब्सटेंस. सो दैट इज अ नॉन रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन. रिवर्सिबल मीन्स बैक साइड, नॉन रिवर्सिबल मीन्स ऑलवेज मूविंग फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन, दे नॉट टेक प्लेस इन बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन. So these are the examples of the chemical changes. So what is the physical change? The physical changes are those changes in which a compound is converted into the another one, but without any chemical change. Okay? And physical change is a reversible changes. Okay? But what happens in chemical changes? The chemical changes is not taking place in backward direction. They always take place in forward direction, and new type of substances form. So here we are writing the difference in between the physical change as well as the chemical change. So first of all, physical change, and the next one is chemical changes. So see guys, in case of the physical change, no new substance is formed. No new substances is formed. But in chemical change, new substance is formed. New substance is formed. Okay. In physical change, it's a reversible change. Reversible change means here a ice is converting into water. But again, water is able to convert into ice. So that change is a reversible change. But in chemical change, it's a non-reversible change. Non-reversible. Non-reversible means burning of paper. Burning of paper. So here, the paper is converting into carbon. That is a forward direction. But carbon is not able to convert into paper. So that is another differences. Okay. See, third difference. In physical change, compound not changing its properties. What is the meaning of that statement? Means to say, if we are going to convert a paper into paper pieces, so the paper always as well as remain after the reaction also. Here is also paper and they also remain. Here is also paper. तो पेपर को कट करने पे इसके पीस में भी पेपर ही रहेगा. नो न्यू सब्सटेंसेस फॉर्म. सो यहां पे कोई भी केमिकल चेंजेस नहीं होते. बट व्हाट हैपन इन केमिकल चेंजेस कंपाउंड प्रॉपर्टीज ओके तो यहाँ पे जो चेंज होंगे उस पर हर कोई कंपाउंड अपनी प्रॉपर्टीज चेंज करेगा. जैसे हमने आयरन ले ली थी, आफ्टर आयरन ले कोर जब रस्टिंग प्रोसेस होती है तो रस्टिंग फॉर्मेशन के बाद किसमें वो कन्वर्ट हो जाती है, रस्ट पाउडर में. तो पहले तो आयरन नेल हैवी सब ऑब्जेक्ट था पर जब वो रस्ट बना तो पाउडर में कन्वर्ट हो गया. सो इट चेंजिंग इट्स शेप ऑल्सो इन प्रॉपर्टीज इज ऑल्सो. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंस इन बिटवीन द फिजिकल चेंजेस एंड द केमिकल चेंजेस. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर द डे. इन द नेक्स्ट डे वी आर वर्किंग ऑन सम अनदर प्रोसेस ऑफ द फिजिकल एज वेल एज द केमिकल चेंजेस. थैंक यू.